What up guys, Cradmosh here, and when I was doing research for SpongeBob SquarePants Rehydrated, I found the collector's edition online, and I mean to say the collector's editions online because there are two of them. And usually there's no point talking about a collector's edition for a game, but I found the one for SpongeBob Rehydrated especially interesting compared to other collector's editions. So, first off, this is just the game. It is $30 or $29.99. And if we were to move on to the shiny edition for the game, the shiny edition includes 6 lithographs. I don't know what this scene is from. And lithographs are little posters, I believe. I think this might be in the caves of Goo Lagoon, maybe in Kelp Forest, I'm not too sure. You get a physical copy of the game, so you get one of these 4. You get wall stickers. You get 3 pages of wall stickers, probably 3 to 4 stickers per page. You get cool socks, SpongeBob socks saying Battle for Bikini Bottom, which is cool. And you get this pretty cool 8-inch SpongeBob, not statue, but a, what do you call these? A figure, a statue? Yeah, a SpongeBob statue. All of this, the game, the little posters, the wall stickers, the socks, oh, and the figurine, it says right there, is $150. $150 for the game, the stickers, the poster, socks, and a figurine. Not that big of a deal, right? It's just $150. A lot of collector's editions probably go up to $100 or $150 because the game is usually $60. So, nothing wrong here, nothing that stands out too much, but there's also the FUN edition. The FUN edition comes with the 6 lithographs, 1 copy of the game, wall stickers once again, the socks, key rings. These key rings, I legitimately think that these key rings are really, really cool. I actually want these. These key rings are pretty sick. Along with those, you get 3 figurines, SpongeBob, Patrick, and Sandy. And the FUN edition, obviously it's more than $150. This edition of the game is $300, $29.99. And that's a little ridiculous. It's interesting that they're selling this. I don't know why. I guess the game has already come out, you know, on GameCube and PS2. They know how much it's sold. They know that there's not much risk involved in this game. So I feel like the game is relatively cheap to make because it is a remake. The game is $38 after all, and usually AAA games are $60. And this game, when it came out, I believe was $40 or when this game came out, it was base price for what games would for what games were back then. I think it was $50 or $40. I'm not too sure. And right now it's $30. I think the $300 collector's edition for the SpongeBob is pretty ridiculous. There's not much to say in this video, it's just more just bringing attention that there's a $300 version of the game with 3 figurines, socks, little posters, key rings, and stickers. I actually want the key rings. I'm not gonna get the $300 version of the game unless I do an unboxing of this and make my money back from doing an unboxing, which I don't make any money from YouTube anyways, so there's no point. But pretty interesting. Would you guys even consider getting the $300 version of the game? I looked up on Amazon and they are not sold out. I can't tell though, because either they're not sold out because they're not selling it yet, or because no one's buying a $300 version of the game for 3 figurines, socks, keychains, posters, and stickers. I mean, compared to other collector's edition games, this is pretty sick. I know other collector's editions of games come with random dumb bullshit. I just think $300 for this game is nuts. I don't know who's gonna get it. But that's all there is to this video. What do you guys think?